Wow, this is beautiful. So how long have you been here then?
34 years now.
What state was it in when you bought it?
It was a big licorice all sort. Every beam was bright black gloss and every panel was white.
Oh God, really?
Inside and out.
Before taking Drew to her sales showroom, Rosie's giving him a private tour of her Elizabethan house. He wants to see her legendary collection of personal antiques.
This is our panelled room where we
Was this here?
It was here, yeah? But if I tell you, it was painted dark brown.
You know, you can always tell a lot about a dealer when you go into their house. You know, you can always see, oh, yeah, they're really good. Well, let's go and have a look at the showroom, and I'd love to see more of the outside of the house as well, please. I've known Rosie for a few years, but known about her for my whole career. A real pro, sort of a bit of a doyen of the antiques trade, well-respected and very much liked by everybody in the business. She's very much sort of antiques royalty, I'd say.
It's a step out of the back door and down the path to Rosie's very grand showrooms in a pair of outbuildings. It's almost like an extension of her own home.
So this is the shop now?
Yeah, we go in here, mind the step.
Not very much of a commute, is it? Talk about handy. It's got the perfect setup, isn't it, to really be working from home these days in the business.
Though off the beaten track, the showrooms are open to the public.
It's wonderful. Look at that bed. This is one of your specialities, isn't
it? Well, we do. We do a lot of four-posters, so we've got 23 at the moment.
Have you?
They've even got one in your size.
Rosie has a certain look, and it's English, country house, 18th century and earlier. Very similar items that all fit together, extremely authentic, which is difficult for me to pick through because I sort of a bit of a magpie. I'll buy anything that I like the look of.
Rosie's high-end collection appeals to a very particular clientele, but Drew's hopeful that there will be bits and pieces hidden away that will be good for his clients.
Oh, I know I'm pulling this out. Is this for sale?
Yeah, everything's for sale. But it's got two broken pieces of glass.
That's a shame, isn't it?
No, three.
There is one thing I find, which is a cast brass lantern, sort of a half size of what I usually buy, but quite a decent quality and a good colour. How much is it, as is?
As is, it's £785.
That's very exact, isn't it? £785. Very. Not many people can do that, can they?
These are just something dropping down, £785.
Needs the glass. Oh, but it's a nice one.
Yeah.
There's glass in the base as well, that looks like. No, it wouldn't. Can I think about that one?
Mm-hmm.
It's about £250 too much. Because I'll want to put the glass back into it, but then I want to spin it over at £150, £200 profit on it, so I can't pay that. So I might have to have a bit of a haggle with her over that.
I think there's a few of those, isn't there?
Hang on, before we go pulling them out, what sort of price are they?
I don't know is the answer to that. What are they worth to you?
The three large copper wall lights, with their curling leaf decoration, reflect the influence of the British arts and crafts movement. They date from the late 19th century and could be worth around £300 each.
They're nicely faded and patinated, and they're big. And they look a hell of a lot better than they really are. So they're a bit fur coat and no knickers, really, but they look great. OK, hit us up. What sort of money do you want for these, then?
What's the worst here?
In this condition, I'd be wanting to pay £300.
About £350?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll give you £350 for
them. There
you go. Okey-doke. There you go, finally. Hooray. Hooray. We bought something. That's great. The wall lights will end up, I think, going through an interior designer's hands because they're bigger than the norm and they're spread out from the wall. It's really quite far, so they're going to need a sizeable building. And somebody with a bit of imagination, a bit of clout, really, to want these.
And with one deal finally done, Drew wants to keep the ball rolling.
There's one piece that we discussed earlier in here I'd like to have a look at again.
OK.
Another armchair. If we could have a look at that.
This leather and chrome PF chair was produced as part of the company's Alpha range. And could be worth around £500.
It's a good name, it's a good manufacturer and collectible. Stylish, and I think I can make a turn on it, and I mean talking about a turn, if I can get it for under a couple of hundred quid.
Drew's already offered £250 for the chair, but Rosie wanted £395. Can he negotiate her down?
How obscenely cheap can it be?
Well, what did you offer? £250?
Yeah, it needs to be, I think that would be it. That, I'm done.
Go, take it.
Are you sure? Oh! Sure, £250.
Okie doke.
Thank you.
I shall have nothing comfortable in here now to come and
it's very
hide away
I'll
on.
Give you that.
But while they're sitting comfortably, Drew's thinking of one last deal on something he saw in the showroom.
I'll have a quick chat about that little brass lantern. Mm-hmm. How much was it again?
£725 is the best on it.
That's the best on it. I'll have to leave it.
You won't.
Yeah, I will.
The cast brass and bronze lantern dates from the early 20th century and could be worth around £800.
To be honest, it's £500 to me. That is what I'd pay for it, and I can't pay any more, because I will probably sell it with the glass in at £795.
That all?
Yeah.
They're twice as much as that at the deck shift fair.
I like to sell.
Have it for £500. I'm here to sell.
You sure?
Yeah. Gosh.
It's very good. Thank you. I don't usually do that. I was just being really honest with you. Sometimes it's just best to be just completely honest and say, that's what I can give you, take it or leave it. Not in a bad way, in a nice way, you know. Overall, today was really interesting for me to see a dealer like Rosie, the sheer volume of stock that she's holding, and this staggering house all in one go. A really good day. Best buyer for me, easily, it was the wall lights. Love them. Very, very happy with those. The rest, you know, I bought a lantern, I bought the nice chair, and then the butter slab. That's fine. That's sort of money in the bank, things that I like and I can turn over. Rosie's a pleasure to deal with. She's a dealer, a dealer's dealer, really. She gets it. She knows what we're all about and what we're doing, and was happy to do that, do a deal, turn the stuff over. It means I'll come back.
Oh, well, I think Drew is so personable. I mean, you know, it's we're dealers, so, you know, there's always a deal to be struck, isn't there?